We have a lot of evidence that impacts occur. We know that they've happened all over our solar system, all over our planet. So this is why we have started surveying for asteroids. We know that actually trying to do surveys that are capable of finding objects well in advance of when any potential impacts occur gives us the widest range of possible things that we can do about it. Civil defense basically means evacuate people, move them out of the way. And this is what you would do if you have very short warning times. So the kinetic impactor is probably the most familiar, and the deep impact mission vividly demonstrated that it is possible to mount such a campaign. Then if you have more time, the gravity tractor idea basically requires a lot of time, but it offers potentially more carefully controlled ability to move an object. So being ready, in my book, means you want to have demonstrations that you've already done. It's also very, very important to have continued support for radar. Radar observations are incredibly important. We're doing a wide range of things that we need. They can offer the best possible tracking of an object short of actually being there with a spacecraft. Being prepared for the future involves having instruments that have both large apertures but also wide-field cameras to be able to capture objects and track them. And it would be really nice to have spectroscopy and colors to be able to get some idea of taxonomy and composition. And international cooperation is essential for this, just because of the nature of the problem. I would say that NASA has a great start on this through the formation of the Planetary Defense Coordination Office. We want to have the connections already made, have them well exercised, and understand who to talk to, regardless of where an impact is predicted to actually land on the Earth.